Recently, I saw in a cartoon, there was a young person who was called up for an interview at a cybersecurity company. The CEO asked the young man, the candidate, tell us why we should consider hiring. The reply came from the young candidate instantly. Sir, I had been to your system and got myself invited for this interview. Very good morning to everyone. Excellency the President, Secretary, Minister of Post and Telecom, Commanders of the Army, Navy and Air Force, Inspector General of Police, our distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Although that was the little humor, it is the depth which we are beginning to realize beyond mere computer, virus and hacking. Needless to mention that the rapid technological advancements in the modern era, especially in the ICT sector, are one way or other forcing us to be connected. And that connection has exposed us to a level of unprecedented repercussions. I'm not an ICT expert, but it is common knowledge where cybersecurity has come in to play a big role worldwide. That is to avoid massive crimes and in the future to prevent cyber wars that would not only cripple economy but also lead to massacres, human races. Today, we are speaking of artificial intelligence, system penetration, corporate espionage, including privacy. But in future, the so-called connectivity can stop even a pacemaker that keeps the heart working, make vehicle accidents happen, bank balances disappearing, making countries declare war against artificially created enemies, and ladies and gentlemen, the list is very long. I'm using simple non-ICT technologies to elaborate my point. It is a cat and mouse game between security experts charged with the responsibility of protecting information and the cyber criminal who threaten to compromise the integrity of data. I do not wish to mention too many specific due to obvious reasons. True enough, the increasing digital connectivity, the whole value chain leads to increasing productivity and efficiency. And at the same time, the looming high levels of threat significantly raising the risk of cybersecurity. In time to come, the risk will be increasing. Be it internal security, external security, politics, economy, bureaucracy, education, or healthcare. Take a simple example of plagiarism in academic world. Day by day, the mechanisms develop ways to catch student culprit, and the youth somehow find a way out. Ask the university student, and they will tell you how to avoid being caught. These are realities, but the danger that we are facing is far too serious. Manipulation of stock markets, money laundering, invasion of privacy, to destroying personalities, and many, many more. Therefore, building of cybersecurity into applications is crucial in addressing such risks. That is what I want to highlight, the need to adapt emerging technologies that will boost the security of information systems from being compromised by the hackers. We all know that passwords and usernames used by majority of data users today are very weak. This makes it easy for hackers to encroach and compromise sensitive data for business entities or security agent is law enforcement. This has exerted pressure on experts of system security to come up with authentication methods. There is, for instance, the cloud that is said to have a significant impact on the transformation of systems security technology. This is with more and more business houses and government agencies and the armed forces embracing cloud technology to store a vast amount of information. Leave alone security forces and the armed forces. Even organizations like Amazon have doubled of their data centered security as at today. We saw some technologies encompassing deep learning, such as machine learning and artificial intelligence. Whenever artificial intelligence and machine learning systems are used with right data, they can make decisions to prevent hacking without any human input. Since cyber attacks can come from any loose end, it is absolutely necessary to keep up with the latest technologies. When the adventures of ICT technologies are transforming the world, they also create a number of new challenges for nation. Use of cyberspace and cyber domain is extremely important for national security over the past few years and in the coming years. Today, all the experts in this domain agree that cyber threats are going to be the greatest concern for nation states and the armed forces. States need to work out contingencies because cybersecurity has become more important in securing sustainability, economic development, and stability of any country. We never heard of cyber terrorism a decade before. A cyber terrorist doesn't want to distinguish whether his cyber offensive action is against public, military, or private sector, as long as his aim is achieved. A conventional terrorist would destroy human and human property. But the level of damage that can be caused by a cyber terrorist would be measured, with collateral damage and others spill over the adversity. No robust protected defense system is safe unless it is constantly monitored and updated with latest technology and innovations. With the stroke of a key, the cyber terrorist can create a massive calamity, and that's the future threat hanging above our head. What is not fully realized is the fact that cyber threats most and often target human behavior. Cyber threats such as social engineering, spear phishing, cyber bullying are mostly targeted through social network, which is very harmful to future generation and especially the youth. One of the ways to answer this question, is cyber security a national security issue? Is looking back to recent history, searching how others have seen the activities in the cyber domain. This is why the recent worldwide threat assessment of the United States Intelligence Committee in 2016 placed cyber and technology at the top, ahead of other prominent threats, including terrorism. It was way back, the United States established the Cyber Command in 2009 to ensure cyber security, and we all know other superpowers were either before or immediately after this. In a macro picture, both experts in this domain, especially in the United States of America, believe that cyber war is inevitable and will later lead to a catastrophe in which some nations may be brought down to their knees. I'm saying what is being